The Team Lally Show was previously recorded.
It's time to enter the world of real estate in Oahu with Hawaii's only true real estate radio show, the Team Lally Real Estate Show. Grab a pen and get ready to take notes. For the next full hour, Hawaii's premier real estate leader, Adrienne Lally, and Attilio Leonardi will bring you the latest in real estate news and real-world strategies on how they can guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it. Now, here are your hosts, Adrienne and Attilio.
Welcome to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the Guaranteed Sold program, or we'll buy it. If you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Well, hey everybody, this is the art part of the show, and today, what does art stand for, Adrienne?
That would be Attilio's Random Thoughts.
And what I want to talk to you today about is that we are in a market that is, I'll give you a multiple choice question. It's either A, super easy to be a realtor in, B, pretty neutral, or C, kind of challenging.
I would go with the C option.
The C option. Okay.
It's a little challenging these days.
Yeah. So here is, here's something that we've learned when it comes to being a top performer. And we know that in the market, business is going to go up and business is going to go down. And that's what we call what? An economically driven business or strategically driven business?
That would be, it's going up and down with what's going on in the economy and the
yeah,
world.
Yeah, the business.
Yeah.
And,
yeah,
you know, I'll tell you right now, there isn't a business on planet Earth that's immune to the ups and downs of the economies. There may be exceptions. People are like saying, well, I know listeners right now, you're going like, well, what about people who sell insulin? You know, regardless of how the economy is going, if you're a type, I forget which one is the type, but I think it's,
if you have diabetes, you're going to need the insulin regardless.
If your body does not produce insulin, you're going to need insulin. So that is not necessarily affected by the economy. But everything else in the economy, those, unless it's, you know, those products or services that are literally like people who need kidney dialysis.
Mm-hmm.
I get it. Those are life and death situations. They're immune to the ups and down swings of the economy, but the rest of the economy isn't. And more importantly, what's the one part of the economy that we're a part of?
Well, that would be with housing.
Real estate.
With real estate and housing. And, you know, like if you have a really low interest rate, and a, you know, that great monthly payment, you're not necessarily going to be super motivated to sell that home and move into a higher interest rate.
Yeah.
Unless like there's a very compelling reason to do so.
Well, here's what I'm going to share with you and our listeners and our people out there on YouTube and all the social media platforms that we're on, is that you need to be working with a real estate team that has a mindset of infinite possibilities. Infinite possibilities. So if you listen to the rest of the show, we're going to talk about all the infinite possibilities that we've come up to help our buyers and to help our sellers. Speaking of someone that always has infinite possibilities when it comes to your financing of your home, who's that, Adrienne?
That would be Jody Tanga, the mortgage genius with Pacific Rim Mortgage.
Hey, Jody.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
What you got
so
for us this week?
We got some economic data that came out today, so I do think it would be fitting to talk about that as it pertains to the market. The June CPI, or inflation rate, came out today.
Mm-hmm.
And after a whole bunch of not the best news, which did lead to this past two-week run of interest rate increase, the inflation data today came out better than anticipated. So we landed at 3% as compared to last year at this time. It was 9.1% inflation.
Mm-hmm.
And then the core CPI, which core CPI is the much more important number of inflation, which just has a certain category of things being compared, and the core CPI came out at 3.8%, and it was anticipated to come out at more like 5.3, 5.2. So that's huge. It really came down this month. It's a huge, not this month, but June for today's data. So it's a huge, huge milestone that I feel the Fed can now really feel like we're getting a lot closer to our target rate of 2% inflation.
Yeah.
So with this information, what can buyers expect over the next, you know, 2 to 3 months? What's your prediction, Jody?
So, if the data continues in this manner, we will see mortgage interest rates improve.
Mm-hmm.
It's not going to be huge. Like, so for example, the difference between today and yesterday was an eighth improvement. So that doesn't sound huge, but that's a big improvement in just one day. And so if I was quoting you a 6.625 yesterday, today I would be quoting you like a 6.5. And that's a big difference. But in terms of like making a huge impact to the buyer, like where, oh, I didn't qualify and now I do qualify, that we're not going to be seeing yet until unemployment numbers increase more. However, from a more bigger picture perspective, in general, as mortgage interest rates come down,
mm-hmm.
there will be more inventory. And then as there is, you know, more inventory, which is like, yay, great news, because now I have more options, there will also be more buyers. So as rates continue to drop, it will get more competitive.
Well, that's excellent news. I love to hear that, because I know, like, with the interest rates creeping up, a lot of buyers have been, you know, getting discouraged because now they're maybe yes. priced out of the price point. So we'll just continue to watch. And I know that, you know, you've been really creative with the strategy of these buy downs. So there's always a way to, you know, create that win-win. Let's quickly touch on that before we let you go. Let's talk about the 2-1 and the 3-1 buy down, Jody.
Yeah. Because that's one of those infinite possibilities.
That's right.
It is. And it is going to help a buyer in a huge, huge way, in that you will be able to temporarily get a lower interest rate and make payment on that lower interest rate. So, for example, with a recent scenario on one of your listings, we talked about a 3-2-1. So mm-hmm. this is going to be 3% lower for the first year, 2% lower than your locked rate for the second year.
Mm-hmm.
And when I say year, that means 12 payments. 1% lower for the third 12 payments, and then back to the locked rate for the fourth year and on. So we're really buying time. I mean, we're buying 3 years of these temporarily lower interest rates to buy this time to be able to eventually refinance into a lower rate. So we're basically saying you have 36 months to ideally bank on being able to refinance in the future, which is a lot more comfortable for a buyer than one year, right? 12 payments.
Mm-hmm.
There's 12 payments is still buying you some time, but it's not as comfortable. So it's a bigger risk. And so with this, you know, that type of monthly payment difference is going to be, you know, almost $2,000 a month.
That's huge.
But just comparing a 6.5 to a 3.5%.
So that's $2,000 a month, $24,000, right? For the, oh no, more than that, $48,000 over the 2 years.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's huge savings for the buyer, and then they get to buy that time where they can refinance when the rates adjust.
That's the question. What's the end strategy?
Yes, is to refinance into the lower rates and just continue to watch with Jody. So
right.
Okay. Well, excellent strategies and information.
Yeah.
We love it when our mortgage genius calls in and educates us and our listeners.
Last question, Jody. Are you guys doing a lot of these, or is it just it's just an option for people to think about?
It's a great, I mean, that's a great question. And it's just like, we are doing them.
Okay.
But it's not as much as we were in the beginning of the year.
Gotcha.
So that's more to get a pulse of like the sellers, because a seller, if they have two apples to apples offers, same purchase price, but one is asking for the 2-1 buy down and one isn't, then we all know the seller is going to go with the one that isn't most of the time.
Yeah.
And that's because the seller is going to net more money. And so in a lot of our instances, while the goal is to definitely go in with it, in some cases, in order to stay competitive, the buyer has to make a decision. Do you want to stay in the run for this particular property, or do you just want to be like, I'll pass because they already have a stronger offer?
Yeah.
And so that ultimately comes down to the buyer's personal perspective, because if they have the time to wait, we are seeing them getting accepted. It's just not every single property.
Well, it's a case-by-case situation.
I think the strategy would be, if you've seen that home has been sitting on the market for like maybe more than 90 days, that seller is probably going to be open to doing some of these strategies, and you're not going to be having to compete with other offers.
Yeah, and they should be open to it, because obviously the home has been sitting, and whatever they've been asking for it is not what the market was willing to bear.
Yep.
So.
Right.
Okay, well, thank you, Jody.
Thank you, Jody.
You're welcome, guys.
Okay, so you can find Jody on our resource tab under Experts We Trust, or just give us a call. We're happy to put you in contact with Jody.
Hey, you know, real quick, before we bring on Bradley from Allstate Insurance, I just want to throw this out there that we have a way of getting an offer on your home if it's been sitting.
Mm-hmm.
Stay with us, and we're going to talk more about it during the rest of the show.
An instant offer.
Instant offer. Mm-hmm. It's almost up there with like instant coffee or like a Pop-Tart.
And even, you know, like with this sell to buy, we have a very creative solution.
Yeah. So. Well, we'll talk more about that in a little bit. Speaking of someone that's got creative solutions, we got Bradley with Allstate Insurance. Bradley. Hey, Bradley, what you got for us this week?
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Okay. You know, there's some people that are buying teardowns in Hawaii right now. And some people think it's the same type of policy as a homeowner's policy. But in fact, when you are tearing the house all the way down to the bottom and you're going to rebuild it, a lot of times they're going to require what's called a course of construction or builder's risk policy. And it does differ a little bit than your regular homeowners. And so to avoid getting in a pickle, when the house does come all the way down and it's demoed down to the ground, give your agent a call because it is a different type of policy. Now, oftentimes, people are calling us when the house is being framed or halfway up. At that point in time, a lot of carriers are not going to accept you to get what's called a course of construction or builder's risk policy. So it's very important that when you are doing a teardown, to give your agent a call to make sure you have the proper policy in place.
Yeah.
Because once the construction starts, it's very difficult to place.
Mm.
And the reason why I'm bringing it up is, oftentimes I get a lot of referrals from other agents or other carriers, because course of construction and builder's risk isn't done by all the companies out there. So, be aware that, be aware that not everyone does it. So if you are going to tear down a house, to make sure you start getting some quotes and some ideas of who does write these. Of course we write them, but be aware, because not everyone does write them.
Well, this is important to know, because, like, so let's give the real-life example. The challenge that you're running into is that the homeowners think that they have homeowners insurance. They bulldoze the home and start rebuilding the new home. If during the construction process, because things happen, wiring, plumbing, flooding, this and that. if something happens, you know, it's not like new construction homes having completely burned to the ground because someone left a wire, tripped mm-hmm. this, or some sawdust caught on fire. If that home burned down during the construction phase and all they had was their normal homeowner's insurance that was in place pre-construction, they're not covered?
Yeah, so that could be an issue, right?
Yeah.
What if the house that they originally had was single story and a little smaller than the two-story
yes.
home that they're building?
Yeah.
And what's common, electrical is common, but what's also common is people going in, vandalizing, setting the house on fire, or stealing
yeah.
material.
Yeah.
Or hurricane comes through when the house is
not finished,
almost completed, but not fully completed.
Yeah.
So there are things that can occur. So it's very, very good to be aware of making sure you have the right policy in place.
So have a very clear conversation with your insurance agent about what your intentions are with this home, right? And
yeah.
we recommend to talk to Bradley, regardless of who your insurance is with right now. He'll take a look at your policy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Well, I guarantee you, with the hundreds and hundreds of listeners that we have, thousands of listeners that we have, somebody's out there doing the same thing,
mm-hmm.
and we just gave them a good friendly reminder.
That's right. Give Bradley a call.
All right,
he'll
Bradley.
Help you. Thank you, Bradley.
Thanks, Bradley.
Thank you so much.
Hey.
Okay. So I guess while we're waiting for another vendor,
let's get back to the infinite possibilities.
That's right.
So buyers, we already talked about one of those things. Hey, you know, interest rates are high, which is reduced, like maybe the initial purchase price. We just sat down with a client today, and they're very, very price conscious when it comes to their mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be moving into retirement. Well, they're already retired and have a fixed income, and they want to make sure that new home that they purchase isn't going to have a mortgage that they can't handle. So they literally just want to make sure that mortgage is low for you people buying a home. So, I mean, what are they going to do to keep the home mortgage on their purchase down? What specifically are they doing?
Well, they're selling their
home. Selling a home.
And they're going to put a very large amount down
yes.
and have a small mortgage.
Yeah.
And probably have some kind of, they're buying new construction.
Yeah.
So they're going to have some kind of lender credit to get that interest rate down.
Yeah.
And kind of ease into that payment.
Hey, here's a tip for you buyers with the new construction. I know D.R. Horton, you know, Evergentry, Castle & Cloak don't want to hear this, but with the interest rates going up, there's no more lotteries. There's
mm-mm.
no more super high demand. So don't assume that just because something is printed on a nice brochure, on a nice website, that's what you're going to pay, or that's what it is.
Everything's up for negotiation.
Everything is up for negotiations. I was at Safeway the other day. I was trying to negotiate a gallon of milk because it's like so expensive. Cashier didn't go for it. But everything, I mean, doesn't hurt to ask, right? So here's the other infinite possibility. Don't go in assuming that what's advertised or what's listed there is what you got to pay. If you have a good buyer agent that maybe works with Team Lally, we're going to go in there with an attitude or with a mindset of a strategy to save you money on everything, terms, price, whatever we can ask for.
So before we head on to the break, I want to talk a little bit more about this. We kind of made a little bit of a modification.
Instant offer.
And just a little bit of a modification to our guaranteed sold program,
yeah.
where we are able to offer a profit share.
Well, let me ask you
in
this.
In the upside.
Before
yep.
I keep cutting you off because we want the listeners to be, what? Huh? Mm. Tell me, Adrian.
Mm-hmm.
But before we tell them that, there's always a reason why different strategies are put in place in the market when we have market. And what is the reason why we're doing this now? What's happening in the marketplace with homes for sale on Oahu and Hawaii in general and around the nation?
They're not necessarily selling as quickly as they were
yeah.
before.
What's happening with the days on market?
They are going up.
And don't take our word for it. If you just Google days on market for average home in a single family home in the U.S., do it for Oahu. And I'm sure some brilliant realtor is going to have all the stats mm-hmm. out there, or somebody will have something out there, Honolulu Board of Realtors, that's going to show you that the days on market for single family homes, on average, some homes sell in 5 days, some homes sell in 500 days, but on average, it's going up. And
yep.
what does that mean?
That means that the prices are going to start to be adjusted
yeah.
until we can meet where they need to be. However, we do have a program that can give you an instant offer.
Well, but hold on.
Yep.
One more thing I want to add to the equation, because people are thinking, like, why do this? Is the second, okay, so days on market is one of the factors.
Mm-hmm.
We sat down with our awesome team leader, Chad Shimabukuro, the other day, and he gave us four factors to look at in his total market overview. Another one was list price to close price.
Yes.
What are we seeing? Explain what those two numbers are, and what were they like before, 6-12 months ago?
So back when the interest rates were lower,
and we had a ton of buyers,
the list to close price was anywhere between 100 to 105%.
Yeah. So what that means, let's say you list your home for $800,000, you would get an offer for $810, $815, $820. You maybe even close at $830, $840.
Yep.
So $800, close at $840.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's take that same home with what's happening with the statistics and what's happening.
You're looking at anywhere between maybe 95% to 100%, because there are some agents and sellers that price it right where they need to be.
Yeah.
And, you know, they get the offers.
Yeah. And pricing is probably, I would say there's three things that get a home sold. It's the home itself. Mm-hmm. And people say, what about location? That's the home.
The condition
of the property. So everything, yep. That's the home, the product.
How easy it is to see.
Yep, the product.
Mm-hmm.
How easy to see, that's all the product. Well, how easy to see, that's going to be more on the realtor, and that's going to be on the promotion. Promotion is, do you have video tours? Do you have virtual tours? Do you have aerial shots? Do you have a ton of data? Do you have a seller's disclosure?
Floor plans.
Home inspection. All of these things in the data when people are looking at it. And is it being marketed on a bunch of sites? Does that listing agent or real estate team have a radio show where they talk about your property all the time every Saturday on AM 830 KHVH? Things like that. But then the last one is the price. And here's what we do know. No matter how good the promotion is, no matter how good the product is, if I'm taking an average home, let's say in Mililani,
mm-hmm.
and listing it for $10 million, just a basic 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,500 square feet on a 5,000 square lot, and I listed it for $10 million. The product is awesome. This thing is totally renovated. It's got everything.
Turnkey,
ready to move in. They probably got brand new clothes in there. And the promotion is just out of this world. I mean, literally, we have The Rock Johnson come by and to our open house and help promote it. And everybody on the planet knows about it. Are we going to get $10 million for that home?
No.
No.
No. Maybe, you know what? Maybe we will, like, 15 years from now.
Yeah.
Or 20 years from now.
$10 million? I'm thinking, like, 100 years from now at $10
million. No, because they're, like, that size home in Mililani is running around $1 million.
I guarantee right you now. Everybody listening to the show and yet to be born will be dead by then, by the time we get the 10
eventually,
million.
Eventually, but not anytime soon.
But not right now, because homes in Enchanted Lakes, we saw an ad, we're going for $60K.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can't touch anything in that area for under $1 million. So talk about the instant offer. Who's the ideal person for this instant offer? What does the ideal person look like? What's their motivation? Why would they want to participate?
Well, the ideal person would be someone who wants to buy again. They need to sell to buy.
Sell to buy. I have a home.
Mm-hmm.
I got a $200,000 mortgage on it. Maybe it's worth $950,000.
The cool thing is that we can also offer a rent back. So you don't need to sell and then, like, get out.
Wait,
if you don't,
Adrian,
have a place to move.
If you give me an instant offer, I don't want to have to move out and stay at the Holiday Inn while I'm waiting for my new home.
No problem.
You can stay at the Holiday Inn called the Holiday Your Own.
That's right.
Your own house.
So.
And, well, wait a minute. There must be some catch. Are you renting it back to me for like $20,000 a month?
No.
No. How are we coming up with that rental amount?
We'll do a rental analysis.
And who's going to provide that at third party at arm's length?
That would be at Duke Kimhan of Hawaii Pacific Property Management, which is actually who's going to be our featured guest today.
Featured guest today. So he manages over 1,000 properties on Oahu, so that he would have him, third party, arm's length distance, mm-hmm. Determine that rent back. And then let's keep going with that process. What does that make available for the seller immediately?
Well, with the instant offer? You have your credit is freed up because that mortgage is gone.
Yep.
And the equity. to go put money down on your next home, and you are no longer a contingent buyer.
Yeah, because we are, like, I'll tell you right now, the new home builders,
they don't want those contingent buyers.
You might as well, you might as well have a raging cold. They don't want to even get within 5 feet of you.
Yep.
But if you have an instant offer, boom. Because what's happening with the new builders and interest rates, the prices and the interest rates?
Yes, the new builders are becoming motivated as well.
Yeah.
Just like the regular sellers.
Well, and yep. Things are going up, and that model that you wanted that's on that particular part of the area is not going to be available because you're waiting for a buyer to come buy your home.
Okay, so we are going to take a break, but stay with us. When we come back, we're going to be talking with Duke Kimhan of Hawaii Pacific Property Management. We're going to talk about their management services and guarantees that they provide.
So stay with us.
Hi, I'm Barbara Corcoran. To sell your home on time for the most money, you need a sharp agent with a marketing strategy that creates the most demand. Bottom line, you need a partner willing to put their own money on the line for you.
In Hawaii, I would hire Adrian Lally and Antilio Leonardi. Their marketing strategy is so effective that if your home doesn't sell on terms you agree to, Team Lally will buy it.
Partner with the team I trust. Go online or call and get your home sold.
Hello, Hawaii. It's Colin Cowherd. Things may have changed in the sports world, but the games must go on. Look, I invest in real estate all over America, and right now with the ultra-low interest rates everywhere, if you're serious about selling your home, you need to talk to my friends Adrian Lally and Attilio Leonardi of Team Lally, real estate group of Keller Williams Honolulu. Team Lally's incredible marketing with 3D tours and its huge database of buyers has continued to sell homes quickly with multiple offers over the asking price. Adrian and Attilio continue to spend tens of thousands per month on marketing to attract hundreds of buyers every month using a unique app that communicates daily with over 3 million luxury home buyers around the United States. Adrian and Antilio guarantee to sell your home at a price and deadline you agree to, or they'll buy it themselves. Give Adrian and Antilio a call at 799-9596 or online at teamlally.com. That's teamlally.com. And start packing.
The Team Lally Real Estate Show continues.
Give it to me, I'm worth it. Baby, I'm worth it.
Welcome back, and thanks for listening to the Team Lally Real Estate Show, Home of the Guaranteed Sold Program, or we'll buy it. I'm Adrian.
And I'm Attilio.
And if you have any questions, just give us a call at 799-9596 or check us out online at teamlally.com.
Our guest today is the owner and principal broker of Hawaii Pacific Property Management. He was born and raised in Honolulu and grew up in Manoa Valley. He was the first restaurateur before delving into the world of real estate.
He has earned numerous real estate designations and continues to educate himself in all areas of real estate to better serve his clients and friends. As a real estate broker, he specialized in investment properties, condos, military relocation, 1031 exchange, and commercial properties. Please welcome our guest, Duke Kimhan.
Hey, Duke.
Hey, I don't know if I wrote all that.
I couldn't even spell
all those.
That's very minimal. Like, there's so much more, you know, to unpack about all of your experience in real estate and in business. I mean, we can go on and
say,
on.
I always say a guest intro is better than a eulogy.
That's true.
It's because
you're not going to hear one of those.
Interesting. Right. But it's interesting to hear someone else talk about it, right? Because people ask you those questions. What have you done before?
Yeah.
What led you into the real estate business?
Yeah.
How do you describe the real estate business today? You get all those questions from interviews and magazines and stuff like that. So it's really kind of weird to hear actual intro of it actually come out.
Yeah, so I think what will perk up people's ears is that you didn't get into property management yesterday. And so tell us about, you know, go back to the beginning. What made you make the transition from the previous career into real estate? Start there.
Well, the restaurant.
It's natural.
Yeah.
It's a natural thing, I think, because you're dealing with customers and you're dealing with a product that you have to, you know, take good care of, and and you're charging somebody top dollar usually for whatever restaurant product you guys delve into. So it's interesting how being on the management and the service side of restaurants to actually get your real estate license. And then you got to learn a little bit something new, but it's the product. The product is real estate now. It's not the food. So you have to give some service to that, and you have to take care of it, and you have to describe it, and you have to do all the things you do in the restaurant business. It's pretty, really similar.
Yeah.
So it wasn't hard to make the transition, but I found that the satisfaction of selling somebody a house or selling someone's house is really 10 times what you would get when somebody tells you, this is the best meal I've ever had.
Yeah.
So
I think you're in your client interactions are hour and a half. Now your client interactions are years.
That's right.
Right.
Yeah. You're in a long-term relationship with all of your property management clients.
So are you like the Chef Ramsay of property management?
That would be a good way to describe it. Never heard it brought to me that way. But here's the property management side was a natural transition too, because as I sold investment properties to people in Hawaii, they would say, hey, can you manage this property for me? Because we don't live here.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
We're just looking for a vehicle to make a little bit of money over a long period of time.
And
very simple.
Yeah, and then talk about that. You know, what are some, with your experience, well, this would be helpful for people that, even if you have investment properties, not everybody's stepped into them with the right, Gary Keller talked about it, thinking hats.
Mm-hmm.
So let's put on our real estate investor thinking hat. If you're going to be investing in real estate here on Oahu, and you're going to be managing it, what would you like to see coming? What would you like to see regarding these properties or numbers or things like that that would be helpful for these people who are thinking, I need to get some investment properties or upgrade my existing ones?
Well, the perfect vehicle in Honolulu, because this is where I manage, is a single family home, usually on the east side, but that's not what usually comes to me.
Yeah.
So single family homes on the west side are normally the bigger turnover product.
Yeah.
And then you have townhomes, and then you have condos. So townhomes and condos normally have an HOA. And I got to tell you that HOA will seriously hurt the amount of net profit you make on your investment property. So if you're going to do it strictly for investment, do not get an HOA fee involved. Sometimes the single family homes now have a small one for $100 or $200, but that's great. That's fine. But when you get those HOA fees that are $500 to $1,500 a month, it's going to severely hurt your net income.
Yeah.
So if you can avoid that as much as possible, then you know, get a single family home.
I talked about this too a couple of weeks ago, or I think was on a live stream, but we got one that's a fixer upper, can use a VA rehab loan in the villages of Kapolei. I've lived there for 17 years. It was $35 for the VOK. Association fees. You know how much it is today? $45. Nope. $45. $45.
Wow, that's
for the association. For the association. There's over 2,000 homes this way, and it's real. It's well managed. $45.
Right.
And they even got a pool with a rec center that nobody goes to.
That's a recommendation right there where to buy.
Yep. Mm-hmm. But keep going. So
single family homes is the best.
The single family homes in Hawaii have appreciated over the course of my lifetime.
Yeah.
When we bought our house in Manoa for $27,500.
Wow.
And, you know, at the time, my dad was a police officer making $600 a month.
Mm.
And so I don't know how he could afford that mortgage, because the mortgage was like $285 a month, something like that.
Yeah.
And you know, it's a third of his paycheck. But my mom was working at the time. They both had an income. And we sold that house 21 years later for $780,000.
Wow.
$27,500.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know how many times that thing, right, appreciated 100%, but it's what happens to the real estate market here today.
Yeah.
In fact, I bought a house that was a fixer-upper. In fact, it had no running water or electrical. So it was a corner lot. I paid $915,000 for a teardown. I put just under $400,000 in it, and I think I just saw my drive-by appraisal at $1.99 million.
Holy cow.
5 years ago. Five years ago.
So how much did you put
in
into it?
In this terrible market.
So it was about 1.3 total, right? 1.3
total. 9 plus 4?
Correct.
Mm-hmm. And you're at 1.9.
Woo! 1.99.
Nice.
Yep. So that's what Hawaii real estate does. It's just a natural position of appreciation every single time that you go to resell.
You know,
so I have a lot of my market is military.
Yeah.
And they normally buy on the west side. So some of them are, you know, they buy townhomes, but a good portion of them are single family homes.
Yeah.
And they can't sell in this market today. I'm talking about today. So they put their houses on the market. They can't sell. So we got to put them up for rent.
Mm-hmm.
So you're getting a lot of inventory then from homes that we're not able to sell.
Yeah.
Correct.
But there's always renters, right?
You know, correct. There's a ton of renters that can't buy right now.
Yeah.
So what I have to inform the seller about is because they weren't looking to sell. They were looking to, they weren't looking to rent their property. They wanted to sell them. Is what's going to happen to their property after 2 years of being an investment property in Hawaii?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you got to look at those tax issues with the owner and say, just be prepared for this, right? And because it's not their primary residence anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've got to be like two of the last 5 years, but then for active duty military,
five of the last 10.
It's two of the last 10.
Two of the last 10.
If they're active duty, if they remain active duty, but if they come off of active duty, it's back to the
Double check that with your CPA.
Two of the last 5.
Yeah.
And that's a good comment to make because I'd say a good portion of my new owners that have come to me lately have been people that cannot sell in this market today.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad that they're coming to you because I know that you and your team are going to take excellent care of their, you know, their now investment property. And when it is time to sell, that home is going to be in tip-top shape.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I always tell them, I said, get other quotes from other property managers, but make sure you ask the tough questions. What's the renting percentage, right? What's the fee to rent with them? Do they do walkthroughs of your property at least twice a year? And then is there any kind of guarantees or warranties that come with turning over a $1 million house to a property manager here in Hawaii?
Let's talk about your guarantees.
Those questions.
Yeah, let's talk about those guarantees. So one guarantee is you're going to be better looking when you're done, when if you go with, bring your property to Duke.
I better add that one.
Better looking guarantee. Well, go ahead. Go through the guarantees.
No, the biggest one is the communication guarantee. So we always answer the phone. That's a big deal. And we stay in touch with the owners. The second one is the rent guarantee where we tell you what the lowest amount of rent you're going to be able to get for your house in that market. But we won't start there to market your home. We'll always start at the highest point. The last one is the eviction guarantee. And it states that if we put a tenant in there and we have to evict them, that we'll pay the eviction costs in getting them out. So, you know, we're going through several evictions right now, and you know the legal fees are $150 an hour for an attorney to go ahead and take your case on to go do an eviction.
Wow!
So evictions are running $3,000 to $6,000 right now with court costs, court fees, and the amount of time the attorney has to go and then serve you, the tenant, your eviction notice to appear in court. And then to file a collection after that, it's just
very tedious.
It's just a whole process. And if you miss a step or like do something out of order, what happens, dude?
Correct.
What happens?
You have to start again.
Wow. Yeah.
You have to start again.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, you know,
really
frustrating. I could watch a YouTube video on brain surgery, but I don't necessarily would want to perform it on myself. And that would be the same thing as trying to evict a tenant. Why do it yourself? And why not be with your guys' team? Because it's not the eviction guarantee isn't the reason. It's probably it should be a good reason for you to have them manage your home. But more importantly, what's the front end stuff that you guys do to minimize that evictions?
Yeah, we do, you know, walkthroughs and stuff. Yeah. And we give you advice on, here's a good one. I just did this today.
Yeah.
I walked your house and the guy was military, and he's leaving, and he has a bunch of kids in a house that has carpet. Mm. And in the house was a cat, and the cat tore up the carpet, right? Yeah. Did that whole scratching thing.
Yeah.
And so he says, oh, we're going to replace the carpet. I said, oh, are you going to put carpet in again? He goes, yeah. I said, don't put carpet in, put vinyl flooring in.
Yep.
And he said, oh, isn't that more expensive? And I said, it is, but it'll last three or four tenants, whereas carpet may not even make it the next tenant through.
Yeah.
That's an excellent tip. So when you have the rental properties, stay away from carpet is what your advice is.
Go with flooring, solid flooring.
So difficult. Yeah. And if, you know, 70% of the tenants today have a pet. So if they have a dog that's going to, he's a puppy,
mm-hmm.
he's going to pee on your brand new carpet.
Yeah.
Going to smell like animal in there too. So highly advise to go to the vinyl flooring, because of course it's not tile or anything, but it will last a long time.
So Duke, on this eviction guarantee, I've not heard of any other property management company guaranteeing their tenants the way that you guys do. So this is like a very unique value proposition that you offer to your clients.
It is. We're the only ones that I know of. And if anybody has another company that does offer guarantees, call the radio station. I want to know.
Yeah.
I
call
just
us.
Haven't
799-9596.
So I want to go back to the rent guarantee, because I know that we kind of briefly touched on it. So let's unpack how it exactly works. You give a lowest price, right?
Well, let Duke tell.
Yeah.
Tell us, Duke.
So I type in the address in the computer,
mm-hmm.
and I look at what the rental range is in the neighborhood, and then I take the lowest amount of rent offered in the neighborhood and apply that to your house.
Okay.
So if it's $2,000, if it's $2,400, uh-huh. $2,900, that's what the lowest amount of rent is in your neighborhood. So mm-hmm. that will be the rent guarantee.
So if the home doesn't rent in a certain amount of time, then what happens with that guarantee? Hawaii Pacific Property Management pays that money to the client?
I've never seen a house start at the low rent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And what we normally do is start at the highest amount of asking rent and then lower the price as we don't get a tenant.
Okay.
So in the months of August and September, it's usually the toughest time.
Mm-hmm.
August, September, December, March. Those are your tough rental months. March because it's spring break, December because it's Christmas holiday, and August and September because we just finished moving all the military personnel onto the island because school starts first week of August. And so these are the toughest months. And so when we take on new owners in those months, I tell them that. I tell them why it might not rent right away. Because that's a question, a standard question we get from an owner. How long do you think this will rent take to be off the market? And, you know, what price do you think you can get it rented for?
Yeah.
And we try to be as honest as we can. So if you gave me your house today, I would say 2 to 3 weeks,
mm-hmm.
maybe.
If it's ready to have a renter move in.
Right.
Yeah.
Because it's at the end of the rental season already.
Yeah.
So I told that to the guy today, and he goes, oh, okay, what happens if I give it to you August 15th?
Mm-hmm.
I go, well, nothing will happen in August.
Well, so Duke,
when
you come across those, you know, those challenging months, I know that you guys like to get creative, and let's talk about some of those things that you do
for the marketing
to motivate the renters to move in.
Sure. Most of the tenants that are moving in that time are creative already. So
mm-hmm.
one of the easiest ways is they come in and they go, hey, you know, my budget is this. So let's just say the rent ask was $2,700. They'll come in and they'll say, you know, our budget's $2,500. Will you guys take that?
Yeah.
And a lot of times we'll go back to the owner and we'll say, hey, Mr. Owner, they offered $2,500. So let's do this. Let's do $2,600. Right, for the first 6 months, and then $2,500 for the next 6 months. So you get some of that back, mm-hmm. and you do meet the tenant's budget.
Yeah.
And it makes sense, right? Because if you don't have a tenant in there, you lose $2,700 for 12 months
yeah.
versus losing $600 for the year.
Yeah, every month you're giving a, you're doing a, you're doing a whether you like
reduction.
It or not, you're
yeah.
doing a rental reduction every mm-hmm. month that it's vacant.
Correct.
I love how you come up with that win-win. So
yeah.
it's like a win for the owner right. and it's a win for the tenant.
Well, you know, there has been times where the owner will offer half off the rent or even the first month free.
Yeah.
Wow.
And we highly recommend they don't do that.
Okay.
How come?
So, because it's just too much of a rent loss. You'll never make that up in
yeah.
5 years of having a tenant.
Yeah.
So, if you rent reduce for $500, that's a lot for a tenant. Say, hey, we do a move-in bonus. The first month, they're taking $500 off your rent.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, $500? We're like, yep. They're like, we're in. They'll take it. But we do not reduce the security deposit. We only reduce the rent.
Gotcha.
So there's a ton of ways that you can reduce your rent to motivate people to take your unit over the next.
Yeah. I think what's your number one recommendation? Just have that thing really in good tip-top shape?
Yeah, and you know, people, 90% of the tenants that are out there have a family.
Yeah.
Right? And they just want something that's safe, that's turnkey. Usually they want, people from the mainland want AC. So we try to recommend that as much as we can, either putting in or leaving in the window ACs or giving AC as a part of an option
yeah.
for a tenant.
So that's a good idea because they stay cool. They keep sending in the rent.
And then the other thing too that I know that you've talked a lot about is allowing pets and then, you know, having like a whole process that you guys follow with this, you know, the pets.
Tell
pet
us about
okay
your
rental.
Pet.
So, yeah.
Tell us about the pet process.
It starts at the application. So when somebody says, hey, we have a pet, so we say pet negotiable under 25 pounds or whatever,
mm-hmm.
then they'll say, yeah, we have a 22-pound dog. We'll say, okay, can you please submit a picture of your dog? So then we send that to the owner. We're like, hey, Mr. Owner, this is the picture of the dog that the tenants want to put in the house. And 90% of the time, the owners say that's fine. It looks like a good dog.
Mm-hmm.
And then, unless it's a puppy.
Yeah.
So, we try to stay away from puppies because they haven't developed their peeing habits, pooping
yeah,
habits, or scratching
house
habits.
House-trained. Yep.
Yes. Big time.
So, with the 22-pound
so
dog...
Once we get the picture approved...
The 22-pound dog, you don't say put him on diet.
Get them down to 19 pounds.
Weigh in like he's going in for wrestling or something.
And then you guys do something a little different too, right? Once that you've identified the home is going to be pet
yeah.
occupied.
Yep.
What is it that you guys
right.
do?
So we put that in the lease
mm-hmm.
that with the pet inside the house, we usually do 3 walkthroughs every 4 months versus every 6 months.
Yeah.
And you know, it's really just to check on the pet. Just to make sure we don't walk in there and just reeks of pet smell.
Yeah.
Or there's not stains on the carpet, stains on the floor, or the owners are good pet owners where they take care of the house.
Yeah.
Super important.
Or that they have, like, swapped out the pet for a much larger dog, like, that's, like, the size of a miniature
yes.
horse.
Yeah.
Correct.
Moved in with a puppy. Next thing you know, they got one pony. From puppy
yeah.
to pony.
That's a true story.
We had a 100-pound dog. I think might have been in one of your
it was.
Units,
yeah.
Adrian.
It was.
And the guy said, oh, no, he's 25 pounds. Send the picture in.
His leg was 25 pounds.
And the dog had his own room, literally. He had a crate that was so giant. And he goes, oh, no, don't go in there. You know, my friend's dog is in there.
Yeah.
We're like, what are you talking about?
You go in there,
goes, no,
he's
no,
sitting
no,
at a desk, he's smoking one cigar, playing poker with his friends
yeah,
on Zoom.
Exactly. The dog was 100 pounds.
In a
oh
third floor walk-up condo, two
yep.
bedrooms, two baths,
yep.
like, a, you know, tiny space.
You imagine the neighbors,
so
too. They must have been kind of scared to go up the stairs at the same time.
If you remember, we gave your tenant a 10-day notice right there.
Yes, on the spot. I was so grateful to have you guys all over that situation.
Well, and it,
he was a military guy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is some flexibility, but not complete flexibility, right? With the pets, and you guys have come up with strategies to manage that, to minimize the risk, but opening up the potential, because that's always, you know, people who have pets, they always dread moving because they're like, oh man, it's going to be hard finding one rental.
Well, I think not with Duke and his team. Yeah. I think that they've got this this whole process organized, and they've got a way to work with it.
You know, we got some. That reminds me of some sellers we have. You know, Carlo and Angela. They have a dog. What's the dog name? Scout,
Ranger.
Mm-hmm. Big German Shepherd, really super fluffy. Mm-hmm. I'm sensitive to pet smells, and I was in there, and I couldn't even tell.
Yeah.
Other than obviously. Ranger was walking around.
They're good pet owners.
Good pet owners. So that's one of the houses we have for sale, and you can't even tell they mm-hmm. have pets or just dogs.
Now, I know that
it's rare, though.
Yeah.
We're coming to the end of the show, Duke. So if there's any last words of wisdom you want to leave our listeners.
For property owners, potential property owners, tenants.
Now's the time.
What do you want to share with them?
You know, when you have questions about what a process is like or what a property manager is like, ask questions. Write down questions. Ask the team. Ask our team. You can call my phone. You know, it's not hard to. You can look on the internet on my website. And you can find my personal cell phone number. Mm-hmm. So you can call it. I'll ask you. I'll talk to you about questions. Mm-hmm. And you know, not all properties are perfect for property management.
Yes.
So there are times when I have to say it just doesn't fit our ask right now. So. Anyway, you know, calling is free, asking questions is free, and basically that's all I do most of my day, just answer questions.
And you're excellent at answering your phone.
Yeah.
He's excellent.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, and returning phone calls.
So call Duke, because he's going to tell you can.
Can, no can.
Exactly. Can, no can.
Thank you, Duke. Thank you.
Thank you, Duke.
Talk to you guys later. All right. Bye-bye.
All right, so you can give Duke and his team a call at 445-9223.
Yeah.
Tell them that you heard about him on the Team Lally Real Estate Radio Show.
Yes.
Again, that's 445-9223.
If you're thinking about buying an investment property, instead of calling a realtor first, call Duke first, because he'll give you the parameters of what's going to be able to be managed easily, have lower probability of vacancies, just less repairs.
He can give the rent. Give
you a rental analysis.
Yep.
You can crunch your numbers and see if you're going to have some positive, neutral, or negative cash flow. And then, you know, and then I'd probably say the next person you probably want to talk to is your CPA, just to get a look at the long-term tax kind of situation.
And then Jody, of course. You want to
get your financing.
Yes, your strategy for the investor financing.
Well, you know, all good things must come to an end, and this is the end of another awesome show, but stick with. Start listening to our show for the instant offers. If you got a home and you're sitting in it, we will literally write you an offer, let you stay in the home and rent it back, and help you buy the next one.
That's right. Too easy.
Too easy.
Too easy. Well, thank you for listening, and thank you to our sponsors.
Jody and Derek of Pacific World Mortgage.
Bradley with Allstate Insurance.
Kenji with Pillar to Post Home Inspections.
John with Kilauea Pest Control.
Duke with Hawaii Pacific Property Management.
Kyle with Impact Wealth Solutions.
Robinson with Fine Line Paintworks.
Chastity of American Floor and Home.
And Jake with Skyta Construction Roofing and Solar.
Ryan with Zero Res Hawaii.
And Jeff with the Loan Depot. If you want to get a hold of any of our team, just go to teamlally.com.
We want to give a big thank you to Leah Rodriguez, our producer here in the studio.
Jee-hoo.
Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have an awesome guest talking about something that'll change your life.
Forever. This is the Team Lally Real Estate Show, home of the guaranteed
sold program. We can't sell your home at the agreed upon price in our time frame. We'll have it bought for cash.
Thanks and aloha.
The preceding program was sponsored by Team Lally.